Nation lives on the Ogallala Pine Ridge Indian Reservation in South Dakota. And they are sick and tired of living in a state of poverty that they feel is imposed on them by the U.S. federal government. So Native American activist Paiu Harris is leading the charge to implement MazaCoin, a cryptocurrency like Bitcoin, as the official currency for the Lakota Nation. Harris says he thinks it could be like the new buffalo for the Lakota. Once, the buffalo was everything for their survival. They used it for food, clothing, everything. It was their whole economy. And he wants MazaCoin to serve the same purpose. Because they are sick and tired of being dependent on the U.S. economy, which constantly screws them over. Every year, about $220 million comes through their reservation. But Harris says less than 20% of that actually stays with the natives in the local economy. Most of that money comes from, you guessed it, casinos. People gambling for a chance at free dollar bills. Meanwhile, the reservation is one of the most impoverished areas in the U.S., according to Forbes. So here they are, a sovereign nation, slaves to the U.S. dollar and culture. Harris is hoping MazaCoin can pave their path to freedom. So, of course, the FBI is already on it. They've already called up the Lakota chief to warn him that Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies aren't legal. This despite the fact that the U.S. Treasury Department has indicated that Bitcoin is legal. Also, federal laws grant Native Americans special legal status, which backs the argument for a currency that is independent of the U.S. dollar. As Harris puts it, they're on sovereign soil, and they have a right to have MazaCoin. And they're not going to ask the U.S. federal government for permission. He says when you have children going hungry, it's time to focus. The Lakota are rebuilding the economy on their own terms, and I, for one, love it. We should all follow suit. The economy is broken. It's no longer just a means for exchange. It's a means to make a few people rich by brainwashing the entire planet into buying into a life of mindless consumerism that is dumbing us down at best and bringing upon our downfall at worst. So I say, you go, Lakota Nation. We should all find ways to declare our own sovereignty, independent from the almighty U.S. dollar and all the many chains that bind us to it. Tonight, let's talk about that by following me on Twitter @TheResident.